A high number of Asians say they feel left out of the diversity groups at work. What's up with that?
Yeah, we got to talk about this. There was this group called AAPI Data, Andrew. Long story short, they have a study that shows that Asians were the group most likely to join a diversity work group at their corporation, but then feel left out of the discussions.
Yeah, so I feel like the big question here is, if Asians are minorities, then how come they don't count as diversity? And if people don't take our struggles as serious, then what can we do about it? So everybody, please hit that like button right now and check out other episodes of the Hot Pot Boys, because this is kind of a serious topic. So bear with us, and you don't have to politicize it in the comments down below, but go ahead.
I think it's clear from the comments from non-Asian people, whether they were white or black or whatever they were, not everybody understands Asian struggles or takes them seriously, right? Some people said, oh, you poor things. Of course, that was sarcastic. Other people said, I'm shocked you guys were even allowed to join. A lot of Asians said, you know, everybody, even progressive liberals will tell Asians that we, other groups have it so much worse, so we can't complain. And that makes me feel invisible, which was one of my original complaints in the first place. So now I'm double invisible because my complaint was invisible too. Somebody said, not everybody believes these tropes about Asians, but a lot of people do. Asians are conservative, white adjacent, and do not count as valid people of color.
Ah, man. Yeah, I mean, when you're talking about Asians, that's a huge, gigantic group, 65% of the world, super hyper diverse.
But only 6% of America.
Yeah, but still, that 6% is extremely diverse. Right. And that's why not all Asians are on the same page and don't all act the same. So it's very hard to put Asians in a box.
Let's get into the internet comments. Someone said, you guys are doing great. So I've seen the macro statistics about income and families. What do you guys need more support for? You guys are making all this dough. And plus, I've been seeing you guys win those little movie awards lately. You guys seem so happy.
Listen, at the end of the day, Asians feel underrated. They feel like they're not getting their fair market value. They're not getting a good exchange rate. They're
right, putting 75 cents on a dollar of effort or whatever.
And you're not being recognized for it, and you think you're doing everything right.
And not saying that other groups aren't either, but Asians are included in that.
Yeah, for sure.
Somebody said the only people who care about Asians are other Asians. Like, the only people who are going to care about us is us, guys.
Man, and it's crazy, but anybody you talk to, that works in corporate America, they've seen this happen, or it's happened to them, where it's like somebody who comes from a similar culture as them, that moves up, gives them a fair shot, and helps them out. Now, it shouldn't be like, oh, you're just boosting them up for no reason, and this is like extreme nepotism. But yeah, sometimes people get overlooked, and sometimes it takes someone of their color to come up and be like, hey, no, I seen this
and,
kid.
And
I,
by the way, guys, I'm not saying this is for everybody, because I remember when I was working in college, I had white and black managers help me out a lot. But I'm just saying, I think in certain fields, Andrew, this is certainly more true than others. I think certain fields, this type of nepotism is way more accepted than others, and this culture is way more prevalent. Somebody said, but I don't even think you could trust all Asians to help Asians. We're also mercenary and willing to throw each under the bus to get ahead. Asians are just trying to climb the ladder, and they'll throw down the person just to move up.
I think this was more true in years past. I think it's changing a little bit. But yeah, it's true that even like Asian families, or even just if you grew up in Asia, like it was already a fairly competitive market.
Yeah, but I feel like this is less prevalent in STEM subjects, Andrew, and more popular in certain fields that are heavy networking based, like media. I would say the whole vibe between Asians shifted from like a -2 to a +1, 3-point spread. In terms of Asians, used to be really scarcity mindset, and now I'm starting to see a little bit more of a growth mindset. I do think it is industry dependent, but like you said, in Asia, it's very like everything's been graded on a curve like your whole life, and that forces a certain mindset. But it might more work over there because that system's set up that way. Somebody said, we're all just minorities. We got to see each other's struggles, even though they are, to be admittedly, different struggles, and because we're all just being oppressed by the elites.
Yeah, and I think that I mean, this makes sense, but I think what happens is that even when you team up together, then there's still a hierarchy within that group. There's always hierarchies. Everybody's always going to,
Uneven distribution of props or resources. Well,
it's like,
or
blah, blah, blah. Oppression is not the same as my oppression, and that's why I think that that always gets complicated.
But I do agree with that in a macro sense, but I do think the micro application can get very messy, and that's where all the details are. Somebody said, we just got to create an Asian-funded world. Asian schools funded by Asian businesses outside of the U.S. mainstream.
Yeah, no, and I think it's because there's still a lot of groups who do this nowadays. Obviously, like, there's Jewish schools, there's Mormon schools.
Catholic schools. Amish is, like, really outside of the mainstream, right?
I mean, obviously, really, any identity is going to have, like, their own type of thing.
I don't think that Asians are trying to do this. generally...
Nah, I don't think Asians are. Maybe some groups of Asians.
Somebody said, boba liberals will always shout down anti-Asian racism because other groups have it worse than them or perceived to be, have a more harsher version of racism than the ones Asians get, and they will throw their own underneath the bus to get more woke points. I see it on Twitter all the time.
Yeah, and it's really tough because I think that it's so easy to believe after looking at news that you got it the worst, though. You know what I mean? Like, what's the real, like, factual ranking of right. who has it worse or, like, how bad everybody's situation is? Like, there's no real, like, set metric for that. So it's kind of just depends on your perspective.
And not only that, it is human nature to be incredibly self-centered and just see things in reference through your own two
for
eyes.
For sure, yeah, yeah.
Somebody said, people didn't consider Asians true minorities until COVID and they saw all the anti-Asian attacks. Previously, they saw all Asians as worker drone NPCs, but now they saw them getting attacked in the media, so it made them see them more as people. So it's all about the media.
Yeah, I think media really affects people who don't have, who don't see it in real life. Or, like, let's say you, like, look at your Asian coworker and you can't tell what they're going through or if they even have any struggles or if they face any discrimination. But then you see a movie or something. But I think that it really depends on, like, the media companies and how much money they can make off these stories, too, because they ultimately are a business and they need to make money.
I think
money.
As I got older, though, I did realize, Andrew, media affects people even more than I thought. I think I thought it affected people at a medium level. I think for some people, it affects them at a high level out of three, like three out of three, to be honest. Somebody said it's not about color. Color matters a little bit, guys. For example, you might get plus one or two or 3 points here, but really being high class or low class is like plus 100 or minus 100. Can't you guys see that the class and the money weighs so much more than the color?
Yeah. I mean, class and race, they are kind of intertwined in America, though.
Yeah, so that's kind of like the only, I guess that's a pretty good counter argument to that argument, even though I think they both have some points. Somebody said, it's true that no group or no governing system in America caters to Asians, but that's what made us strong. Mm. I like it. Push, give me more barriers. That's what I like. So we got to quit petitioning the system and wasting our time on just making ourselves strong.
Give you more barriers? I don't know about that, but yeah, I get that this is a common comment and people are just like, hey guys, listen, no group's going to really care about us. If you join that group or you join this group or you keep sucking up to this group, it doesn't matter. You just have to just put your head down and work because that's how our parents did it.
Right. The only thing about that is like, I'm like, how do we work? Do we just work as individuals? Do we work in teams, loosely linked teams? Like, what's the actual process of like putting your head down and working? Like, that is such a simplistic statement. Like I said, guys, all these comments went all around the world and back around, you know, micro to macro. I think a lot of them were interesting because they didn't really address the whole DEI in the workplace thing specifically, but they were talking about more macro factors. Andrew, let's just get into our takeaways. Is it difficult to compare people from the Eastern Hemisphere entering a binary from the Western Hemisphere where like racism and all these things were already sort of defined as like this group versus that group, whether it was like white versus black and brown is in the middle or like, then you're just inserting like yellow or like yellowish people.
Man, it's so weird. I think, and yeah, this is like the $1 million question. I just don't think we fully fit in. Just
right. You're trying to fit this piece into whatever this thing is going on over here.
That's why we make so many videos about this. And that's why there's a new think piece written every single day about being Asian, because it is a very, very weird place to be.
And it's hyper like tangled and it's difficult to untangle. Even different writers, the way they untangle it differently and come to different conclusions. I mean, Andrew, how do you rank problems?
All right. So I thought it was interesting because I was also thinking about like sports injuries. How do you rank sports injuries, right? Well, you rank it kind of like based on how long that person is going to miss the season, right? How many games are they going to miss? Or how do you rank, how do you rank anything, I guess? But there's just no real metrics on how to rank problems, I guess.
Right, like I think the Asians really go through a lot of otherism. I do think they go through racism as well. But other groups, they may go through a lot more racism than they do otherism. Now, otherism is just almost feeling like a dismissible, invisible, unwanted, like alien. Whereas I feel like other groups, let's just throw it out there, more conventionally when we talk about ethnicities, black or brown, they might be more like viewed as part of the Western Hemisphere natively, but there's more like contentiousness, but they're not viewed as an alien.
Mm.
Somebody said, why don't you just create a second gen immigrant work group or an Asian work group that can more cater to your specific needs at work?
Well, there's going to be a bunch of different work groups then, for sure. There's going to be...
And I think that's actually how more it is in like a tech company. I think it's more specified for each niche. I guess at the end of the day, is it on Asian Americans to support each other? I would like to think so, but like I said, obviously you saw in the comment section, a lot of people are like, well, you can't even count on Asians to support each other.
Now, I think that's why you got to focus on all the possible things that could unite Asians right now. And maybe it's not always on a deep level because Asians grow up differently, but I'll tell you this, man, there is more and more reason for Asians to feel somewhat close with each other, or at least not feel like, oh, like, dude, that's the only other Asian man. I know he doesn't understand how I feel. I'm like, dude, there's so much literature, so much has happened in the past 3-4 years. Like, there's something to talk about, and there's something to bond over with. I'm not saying you guys have to be close. I'm not saying you guys have to help each other out. I'm not saying you have to hook each other up, okay? Maybe that's not even how good business works all the time, right? But definitely, I mean, I think that that's one of our missions, right? Is, like, whether or not we're showing, like, we're just trying to have these conversations, and any Asians who watch these videos are going to like understand other Asians' perspectives, I guess.
Yeah. Let us know what you think in the comment section below, guys. Like we said, I think it's a really difficult discussion to have, but it's multi-layered. Try to keep it civil. Do not, you know, try to politicize it. At the end of the day, man, we just analyze the comments and this crazy thing called people from the East, but we're living in the West. All right, you guys, let us know what you think in the comment section below. Until Hop Hop Boys, we now.
Wow. Until next time, we out.